be checking in with you later on this big story. Our General Motors coverage continues on Local 4 and online. New at 5, what is behind the timing of the announcement? Rob Maloney will take a look at several factors. And new at 6, Dennis Gillian is looking at the death of the Chevy Volt and what that means for the industry. We'll be adding these stories to our online coverage at clickondetroit.com. Winter storm has whipped through Michigan. Some of us escaped the worst. Other areas were covered with a few inches of snow. On your screen, you can see some of that snow that fell near Lansing and Charlotte. Now, there is a live look at Metro Airport, which is seeing flight delays and cancellations throughout the day. And then a live look at Mount Clemens, a wet mess. Right now, let's get to Ben Bailey for the current conditions. Hi, Ben.
Yeah, Karen, it was just kind of a nuisance for a lot of us. A lot of the roads, at least the main roads, just wet this morning. And this is the last of that snow that we're looking at right now on 4 Live Radar. And most of this is snow. You can see up here around Fort Huron, of all places. It's actually rain that's being reported. And that's what we got from the reporting station just a few minutes ago. Some snow showers there in Mount Clemens and a couple flurries in Lapeer and Pontiac. Everybody else is under cloudy skies, dry conditions. But temperatures tonight are going to start taking a tumble. And it's going to be colder than what we woke up to this morning. In fact, we'll already be in the 20s here by midnight in most locations. Add to that a wind of about 10 to 20 miles an hour, and you're talking wind chills in the teens for tomorrow morning. Plus, with those sub-freezing temperatures, we could have more slick spots on the roads tomorrow morning than what we woke up to today. We'll take a look at all of that and see if the temperatures will actually go the other direction anytime soon.
The former president of Michigan State University was in court today. Faced criminal charges related to the Nassar scandal. Lou Ann Simon faces 4 counts of lying to police during the investigation of Larry Nassar. Moore alleges Simon knowingly and willfully made statements about the Nassar investigation that she knew were false or misleading. The felony carries a prison sentence of 4 years. If convicted, Simon was released on a $5,000 personal bond. Investigation is underway right now after a trooper-involved shooting happened this morning in Livonia. Police say it started as a domestic situation that turned into a chase on eastbound I-96. The suspect turned around and then went westbound, ending with a trooper shooting the suspect on the highway. Westbound I-96 was closed for hours during the morning rush. We're told the man is suspected of shooting his girlfriend at a FedEx facility in Livonia. Both the suspect and the victim are listed in critical condition at the hospital this hour. Mayor Mike Duggan is stepping forward to address what he calls extortion by a local businessman who's made several claims about the mayor's residency and his personal life. Robert Carmack is involved in contentious lawsuits with the city of Detroit, all stemming from the city evicting him from his collision shop. Carmack hired a private investigator to tail Duggan and has video of the mayor making frequent stops at an address in Wixom. The mayor says no matter how painful the consequences may be, he is not giving into these threats.
This is a terrible situation. I have to choose between protecting the interests of the city or protecting my family. But the mayor of Detroit has got to put the interests of the people first.
Duggan has now asked state police to open an investigation into Carmack's threats. First of all, we're trying